What's going on, Monster Jam fans, and welcome to the video. I'm your host, Avengers Racing, on Instagram and YouTube, aka Pizza Wayne also, and thank you for joining on this fine evening. Today is my first legit commentating show at Minneapolis 2019, which was a great show. I remember watching it on Facebook Live, and I was excited every other freestyle run. It was an amazing few runs, and I hope you guys enjoy. And if you already watched the show, I hope you get more enjoyment out of it this time, as I'm going to be commentating it. So hopefully everything turns out well and you enjoy the video. If you do enjoy the video, make sure to leave a thumbs up, and if you love the video, hit that nice subscribe button. Before we start the video though, I want to give a nice shout out to that one gamer2k19, a great guy that I met at the World Finals this year, who's going to let me use his content for a Minneapolis show. He filmed a great video, so we'll be using his video to commentate this event. So shout out to him. Make sure to go check out his YouTube. I hope you guys enjoy the video, and I'll see you in a moment. This is Monster Jam. Ladies and gentlemen, coming first up onto the track, Ryan Anderson and Son of a Digger. As we're waiting for him to come out of the pits, Ryan has had a great 2019 year and season. He's had some incredible moments here at Minneapolis in the past. So let's see what he could do this time here at Minneapolis. As he's revving it up for the fans coming around the turn. He loves getting the fans excited before his runs, and he loves revving it around the stadium. A few other drivers did that too. As it looks like he's going to line up for the, as I like to call it, send it ramp. Let's see what Ryan's going to do here. One of my favorite Fell drivers and an amazing piece of equipment, if not one of the best Monster Jam trucks, as he's going to start off with some huge air. Some nice momentum coming off of the first jump. Drifting around the corner here. Some good air so far. Gets a little stuck on the bus stack, but that's all right. It's Ryan Anderson. He can pick it back up in no time. Ryan in the corner here. He's flooring it. Huge air. Nicely done so far by Ryan Anderson. Ryan out a little bit of a wheelie over that racing ramp. Drifting around the turn here again. More nice air. Into a wheelie. Nice combo from Ryan Anderson. Coming around the corner here, over the bus stack, huge air. Oh my gosh, Ryan is sending it tonight. Incredible air from Ryan Anderson so far, and some nice momentum. Uh-oh, it appears he has a flat at the left rear. Oh, hard hit on the front right. Ouch, that definitely damaged the truck. Another hard hit on that front right, as he's gonna try and brake before he gets into the barrier and reverse. No RI from the officials so far, so he's going to venge on. Oh, Ryan is putting this truck through misery. What was that? Oh, my gosh. 180 wheelie? I've never seen that. That was incredible. Ryan Anderson spinning some donuts now. That poor BKT tire is on its last life here, as Ryan is going off, just flooring it anywhere he can, digging up the dirt. Incredible run so far. He's definitely lost some momentum, but these incredible, like, crazy moves are definitely picking up. Let's see what he could do with a damaged truck. Oh my gosh, what was that? Ryan Anderson is going insane here in Minneapolis. As the light is ready, he's gonna end it off with some awesome donut cyclones. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Ryan Anderson and Son of a Digger. The fans are hyped. Ryan's hyped. You see him out of the truck with his hands up. He's fired up after that run, and I don't blame him. That was incredible. As they're going to show the highlight reel now. Oh, hard hit from Ryan. He gets that crazy wheelie with that flat tire. It spun him around. Man, Ryan knows how to drive a damaged truck. And Ryan Anderson's going to take the lead with a score of 8.714. Up next in our freestyle competition, it's Jim Kohler in Avenger. Sadly, he had to turn down the audio because the Avenger theme song will get copyrighted. And the video could get taken down also, so I don't blame him. So you're barely going to hear the engine sound. That's all right. We're just going to watch Jim send it probably tonight as he's doing a little parade lap around the track before he gets off in his freestyle. Rocking that beautiful 57 Chevy green body. Beautiful body. And that's Jim Kohler's first hit here off the middle stack. That started time. Let's see what Jim Kohler can do here tonight. My favorite independent truck and driver, Jim Kohler, is an absolute beast. He knows how to send it and has sent it in the past. This new chassis has really helped him get some huge air. But he's had some issues in the past and some early breakage. So hopefully he could venge on tonight and continue his run and fulfill time as he's getting some huge air. Oh my. Had to brake before the next ramp. That's how much air he got. Rounding the corner here in that beautiful 57 Chevy body. Over the center ramp. Nice air. Lands it up on the pad. Gets a little cattywampus up there. Shout out to you know who for using that quote. As Jim Kohler is going to go around the ramp right here. Some good momentum so far. I think Jim got to pick it up a little bit after Ryan's run. That was insane. But Jim knows how to send it. He knows how to put down a freestyle run as he's going to try his best here tonight. Having a great run so far as I believe he's lining up for the backflip. Nope. He just tempted you fans. Gonna get some nice air off of that one. Lands a little hard on the right side. No need to fear. Jim Kohler is here. Going for some more big air. Maybe into a slaply. Oh, if he gassed it a little bit there, he possibly could have got one. Oh, I think he's lining up for the backflip now, fans. Let's see if Jim Kohler can land it. First one to hit it tonight. Huge air. And he lands a hard hit on the right rear shock. Ooh, that truck must have taken a little bit of damage there. As what's Jim Kohler going to do here? Looks like his rear steer is locked to one side. As I believe he's going to end it with some nice donuts here tonight. Give it up for Jim Kohler in Avenger. As we wait for the scores from Jim Kohler. A very solid run. I don't know if that will take the lead. Ryan Anderson had it. Crazy run before this. Jim's gonna have a little bit of repair work to do with the crew, but a solid run overall. We'll see if that takes the lead. He did get a backflip in there, so we're gonna have to wait and see what happens. Let's see. Scores are 5-8-0. That currently takes second place in your Monster Jam freestyle competition here at Minneapolis. Up next, it's Shane England and Big Kahuna, a new beautiful body style that was presented this year. Shane hasn't had the best luck with his truck this year, but he finally got it fixed later in the year. But these freestyles would just suffer from the truck malfunctioning. As he's going to do a little bit of a parade lap around the freestyle track here, I believe. Shane England, overall, amazing guy. I was able to meet him this year at Tampa. And he had an okay run at Tampa. His truck was really bad there, so he did what he could. But he started off freestyle with some big air. Oh, and a bad crash. Ouch. Poor Shane England. That isn't what he wanted. As it sounded like the truck had some engine problems there. It popped, and it just nosedived right into the ground. As we await for the scores from Big Kahuna, I doubt he's going to be able to refire and go in his freestyle run from that one. That was a hard hit. Yeah, it's looking like he's going to get off the track here. His steering is definitely hurt after that one. There's something pouring out of the bottom there. He wants to continue, but I don't think it's going to be able to go. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Shane England and Big Kahuna as he's going to drive it off the track here. or attempt to. As we wait for the scores to come in from Shane England. I imagine it's not going to be too great of a score. Only had two hits. Only made it a few seconds in the run, sadly. Scores are coming in for Shane England, Big Kahuna, at a 3.160. That'll take third place in your freestyle competition tonight. As next up in our freestyle competition, it's Steve Sims and... front hood scoop all covered up, or the grill should I say. Steve Sims gonna come out here with some nice momentum, nice slap wheel. The fans love seeing a good slap wheel, and I do especially. Steve Sims is a great independent driver though. He's been running for a couple years now, definitely a veteran in the sport. As he's coming around the corner here over the bus stack again, nice air. The fans like seeing some different angles on these hits, but it's not as technical as it used to be. I think the fans like the big air and stuff more than the technical jumps. As Steve Sims is lining up for the send it ramp, as I say that, some nice air lands it back on the top. Steve Sims having a good run so far. Needs to pick up the momentum a little bit, I believe. Definitely hasn't hit as much as Ryan Anderson. Over the bus stack again, has hit that the third time, I believe. But from the backside. And he's going to sling into some donuts here. Some solid donuts from Steven Sims and Stone Crusher. Do the fans like the donuts? I will take a dozen, please. He's still going. Man, maybe I'm going to get two dozen. Some great donuts from Steven Sims. Uh-oh. I thought it damaged the truck there for a minute. I don't know. But that's going to end the run there for Steven Sims. Some nice donuts to end it. Give it up for Stone Crusher, Steve Sims, as we wait for the score. If the score isn't recorded, I will find it later and put it in the bio. As he drives back into the pits next to Big Kahuna. As you see the highlights now, some big air from Steven Sims from that racing jump. And some solid donuts to end his freestyle. Definitely the best donuts of the night, other than Ryan Anderson's crazy 180. And Stone Crusher is going to get a 5.919, I believe that was. As next up is Cynthia Gauthier in Monster Mutt Dalmatian Ice. Fan favorite truck coming out here tonight. Cynthia's going to start off and with a nice big wheelie. Good start for Cynthia. She's definitely one to be reckoned with, as she's won a few freestyles. Huge air over the bus. Anyhow, Cynthia is a great driver. She's definitely improved her racing and two-wheel skills, but her best is freestyle, in my opinion. Some more big air. I was talking to her back at Tampa, and she said one of her favorite types of tracks is the muddy tracks, because she gets to just drift around everywhere. But she does great on a regular track. Oh my gosh, she is sending it tonight. Nice combo. And brings it back on all fours. I would say all pause, but this is a monster truck. As she's just getting the biggest air tonight. Nice slaply riding it out all the way to the backflip. Ah, she's going to have to back it up. But that does not deduct unless the fans want it to. She's going to send it once again. Some more big air from Cynthia. She's really putting on a run tonight. This could contend for the lead. Ryan Anderson had a great run, but his momentum really dropped when he lost that right, it was a left rear tire and went flat. But he was able to put up a great run. But Cynthia is definitely coming for him with this run, as I believe she's lining up for the backflip here. Yes, she is. Ladies and gentlemen, get on your feet. Can Cynthia land it? Let's see. Huge air off the backflip. Beautiful landing. The back goes up a few feet. That was a textbook landing for Cynthia. Huge air. Oh, my gosh. Cynthia is going off. She probably got a neutral there from that huge air. Probably knocked the shifter over. Some more big air revs it up in the sky. And that's going to end Cynthia's run. Give it up for Cynthia at Monster Mud Dalmatian Ice. She is hyped up, hitting the top of that truck, waving to you fans. And everyone is cheering for Cynthia and on her feet. Well, let's see. Will that take tonight's lead in the freestyle competition? I would imagine so. She's patting the dog and putting off some nice dance move. As we go to the instant replay, awesome slap, Lily, right there. That was a few hits in. Let's see. Ryan Anderson has an 8.714. Score's coming in. At an 8.899, your new leader, Cynthia Guthrie, in Monster Mutt Dalmatian Ice. Up next, Brian Wright and Hooked. Fun fact about Brian, he's a great guy, but at Tampa this year, he only had 2 freestyle hits and slid right into the wall, my section. And I felt that. That was a hard hit. Left a nice dent into the wall. As his time started that first hit, starting off with some good momentum, I believe, over the bus stack. Huge air. Nice wheelie. I love seeing them pop it into a wheelie after some nice air. As Hooked is another one of my favorite independent trucks. I love the design. I like the driver. Overall, it's a good truck and a good fit for Brian Wright. As Steven Sims Jr. Used to drive this truck, but it wasn't the pickup version. And he got his first freestyle win at Tampa 2015. Sadly, I was not there to witness it, but that was his first ever freestyle win, and it would really lead him on to become a Monster Jam driver. And I haven't heard from him ever since. I think he's doing the overseas tour. As Hooked is having a great run so far. Brian Wright sliding around the turn here. Some more nice air. He's keeping a solid momentum. The fans like to see momentum. As I believe his truck shut off, that's an RII or just a shutoff. As there are 46 seconds remaining for Brian Wright. Let's see if he can refire. Hopefully he can and continue his freestyle. Has 46 seconds left. I imagine he could fire back up unless the battery's dead or something. The officials are going out there. I think that's going to end it, ladies and gentlemen, for Brian Wright and Hooked. I don't know what happened to him. Must be a battery issue or the tech official saw something broke. But give it up for Brian Wright and Hooked as we go to instant replay. Brian had some solid hits, some nice air. But I don't think that'll be enough to take tonight's lead. It'll definitely take over Big Kahuna's run. And the scores are coming in right now at a 5.049. Your fifth place contender so far is Hooked. As it sounds like next up in our freestyle competition, it's Scarlet Bandit coming onto the track. Don Creedon, a great driver, or a good independent driver too. Her husband, Jimmy Creedon, drives in Monster Jam as there's something pouring off the back of the truck there. Oh no, disappointing. What happened? I hope that wasn't shock fluid or something. I think that's gonna end it for Scarlet Bandit's run already. Don Creedon probably not happy with that one. The officials saw that smoke and stuff come out. It looked like liquid or fluid to me. Another disappointing freestyle, but it's not Don's fault. It's the truck's fault. It failed, sadly. The equipment won't always hold up. That's okay. Oh, they're going to let her go again. Correct me wrong. Don Creedon's going to continue on here. I believe she has a damaged shock, but it's not going to affect her. Well, it will affect her run, but it'll definitely take an impact on her physical health. She'll definitely feel those hits. She's trying to do some two-wheel skills here. I don't know. Definitely struggling right now, but she wants to keep going for you fans. I don't know what's happening. There's something going on with that steering. I don't know. It's smoking down there really bad. I think this is definitely going to end her run. I don't know what Dawn Creedon can do here. I just can't imagine her being able to freestyle the way she is right now. Yeah, that's going to end it for Dawn Creedon. Give it up for Scarlet Bandit and Dawn Creedon as we wait for the scores. Sadly, that's going to end her run short as we await for the scores from the fans. The way you score is take out your phone, you go to judgeszone.com, type in the code, and then you put your tire from a 0 to a 10. They average out the scores, and then the score's coming out. So let's see what Dawn Creedon gets in our freestyle competition tonight. Sixth place with a 3.515, I believe. If not, the correct scores will be in the comments as this video skipped very quickly. As next up, it's Megalodon. I believe that is Justin Sipes coming out onto the track. Another fan favorite truck. If this is Justin, Justin has had an incredible year. He's a very underrated driver in my opinion. Had a great World Finals 20 run, but sadly ended short. Also had last year's World Finals was great. As he's going to cruise around the track here in the Megalodon machine. The Shark from down below coming around the track. A fan favorite truck. Starting off with some big air. Starting in first gear, I believe. That was really high rev. Over the back of the Sendit ramp. He's a little crooked, but that's all right. That Shark can handle anything. Sounds like he's stuck in first gear right now. Again, a nice slap wheelie. Some great stuff from Justin Sipes. Still in first gear. Can't get into second. Hard hit there. Uh-oh. Oh, hard hit on the front right tire and shock mount. Justin's definitely not happy with how his truck's going right now, but it's not going to stop him. He's going to keep flooring it until that tranny. Oh, nice save. Back on all four, BKT tires. Brings it back on all fours. Let's see what Justin can do to continue and follow that up. He's revving it up toward the bus stack. Some more nice air. I bet you Justin would do a lot better, but sadly the truck is still stuck in first gear. They can't do anything about it. Some nice air. That transmission's definitely going through heck right now. Oh, as the front right looks like it's not rotating anymore. The truck's starting to give up there. But he's going to continue on. He's definitely filling time, doing better than the few trucks that came before him. Get him some nice big air. Justin's not afraid to send it, especially in first gear. I don't know what Justin can do here. I don't know if this could take the lead. What's he lining up for here? Oh, I thought he was really lining up for the mini. Oh, huge air. Oh, my, hard hit onto the side. And a big fireball to end it off for Justin Sipes and Megalodon. What a crazy crash. What did you fans think about that run? Put in the comments down below or the live chat. I don't know if that'll take the lead for Monster Mutt Dalmatian. Cynthia had a pretty good run. Let's see if that could follow it up and maybe take the lead. I see that taking second or third place, though. Let's see if I'm correct. As we go on the instant replay highlights, Justin had some big air, especially with that first gear. Nice slap wheelie from the shark. As Montserrat Dalmatian has an 8.899. Let's see what Justin's score is. Scores are coming in from the fans. At a 7.393. That'll take fourth place. I was one away. I said third or second. As next up onto the track, one of my favorite fell drivers and favorite trucks, it's Bakugan Dragonoid coming onto the track, driven by Camden Murphy. Another fan favorite. It was built this year in 2019. Built off an anime series, I believe. I'm not a huge anime guy, but may start watching it more that they have the Bakugan Dragonoid. As he's lining up for his first hit here, some nice air over the bus stack. He's going to try and follow up Cynthia's run from a few runs before and try and take the lead. We'll see what Camden Murphy can do tonight. Fun fact about Camden Murphy, he's actually a NASCAR driver and also a Monster Jam driver. The only driver in Monster Jam to do that, and a NASCAR. As Camden Murphy's having a great run so far, drifting around the turn, a great momentum. He's going for that lead. Huge air. Oh, wicked bounce. Nice wheelie over the ramp. And he's going to hit the center ramp from the back. Gets him a little twisted up there. But that's okay for Camden. He knows how to control the truck. He was in the Arena Series for a few years and then had the opportunity to drive this truck. And now he's in the Stadium Tours. Almost got a stoppie there. As he's lining up for the backflip ramp, I believe. Let's see what Camden can do. Can he land it? Huge air. Oh, hard landing on the back, but he lands it back on all fours. No RI from the officials, but that back end's definitely a little damaged. The rear steering is cocked, but he's going to continue on. Oh, plows it into the ramp. Can he save it? Oh, he doesn't, but an incredible crash from Cam Murphy. 38 seconds left on the clock. 36 seconds, I believe. Give it up for Camden Murphy and Bakugan Dragonoid as we see the instant replay highlights. What an incredible run from Camden. He gave it his best. Got a little crooked there on the ramp, and it just took him over there, especially after that backflip. He had some damage as he turned into a lowrider on the instant replay. As we're looking for the scores from the fans. Current score is still held up by Cynthia at an 8.899. Well, I take the lead. It's up to the judges, which are the fans. Let's see. A 8.324. That'll take fourth place currently in the freestyle competition. Will anyone be able to conquer Cynthia's run and take the lead? We will have to see. But coming out of the tunnel next, it's that crazy bull, El Toro Loco, coming onto the track, driven by Brad Allen. Starting off with some big air. Brad Allen has the felled El Toro Loco body on his chassis. Great thing for the independent teams. That way they can actually run their truck pretty hard and don't have to worry about paying for the body panels. Nice air, beautiful wheelie. One of my favorite moves is the classic wheelie. As Brad Allen's going to try and take that lead. Sounds like he's also in first gear. I don't know. But his truck definitely takes these hits pretty well. As he's definitely upped this game this year in 2019. Oh no, it sounds like that transmission's starting to give up. Oh. I think that's going to end it for Brad Allen unless that tranny will give him some go. Doesn't look like it's gonna though. Something definitely happened in the truck. 67 seconds left, but I think he's gonna end it early, sadly. Give it up for Brad Allen and El Toro Loco, sadly, with an early ending. But we'll see what the fans put in the scores. I don't see that taking the lead, but definitely a top 10.
No mini flips yet. many flips yet.
Brad Allen definitely having a solid year this year, but sadly his equipment breaks early this run. He runs with Jim Kohler. And scores a 5.005. That'll take 8th place currently in freestyle. I was going to say he runs with Jim Kohler in the trailer. As Jim Akrenin's coming out to the track. Going to start out with a new hit that nobody has hit. Tried to get a wheelie out of it there. Couldn't quite get it. But Jim Akrenin's going to come out with his what the fans called rock crawler, bounty hunter. Beautiful slap wheelie. Rides that baby out. Onto the mini flip. Doing some skate 3 tricks right there. I just love the roar of this truck when it comes onto the track. It has a very aggressive design. And for the World Finals, he actually had the 5-finger death punch design, which looked amazing on it. I asked him about him and said it wasn't a sponsorship. They just lived close to him and he wanted to have a special paint scheme for the World Finals this year. So Jimmy Crean's definitely a cool guy. Some huge air from Jimmy. When this truck was first built, it looked a little different, but a lot of the fans criticized it and called it a rock crawler. But he proved all of them wrong and had a pretty solid first year of this truck. And now in 2019, having an even better year, has the truck dialed in and having a good freestyle tonight. As he gets some crazy bounces, he's going to line up for the backflip maybe. Nope. He's just tempting you fans. He's going to continue on. Some more nice air from Jimmy Creedon. Beautifully landed on the other side of the ramp. He's going to line up for a side hit off the bus stack. Nicely done. Gets a nice bounce out of that rear end whenever he lands decently hard over the racing ramp here. Will Jimmy Creedon go for the backflip tonight? Let's see. Looks like that's where he's going right now. Ladies and gentlemen, get on your feet. Jimmy Creedon's lining up for the backflip. Here he goes. Perfectly landed. Oh! And that left rear tire comes off completely, taking off the shocks and whatever is back there. Hard landing, but he gets the backflip. I don't know how much time was left on the clock, but he had a solid run. I think that's a top 5 run. What do you fans think? As we see the instant replay highlights, had a great slap wheelie. Some nice air over the racing ramp. And I believe he almost completed time. He got pretty close. Score is still held by Cynthia. As we await for the scores from the Monster Jam fans. Comes in at an 8.149. That'll take 5th place. I was right on the money. Top 5 finish so far. But ladies and gentlemen, coming out of the tunnel, it's Tom Entz and Fire Max D. Your two-wheel skills champion from this year's World Finals 20 event. Also cheered on his son Colton during the encore stunt. Tom Entz loves to go around and rev up his truck for the fans and get them on their feet. Let's see if he does it out here. One of the nicest looking fire trucks out here. Let's see what Tom can do as he's just speeding throughout the track. I think he's going to start out over the bus stack. Huge air to start off. Tom Entz is definitely going for it. He's another person. I'll send it. And he sent it right into Jimmy Creedon's bounty hunter. Jimmy may not like that. Tom Entz definitely knows how to floor it and send it. He is a professor of big air. Some more nice air over the bus. Really gets that rear end kicking up. As I guess he crashed during racing or two-wheel skills. So that's why the front clips off and he was in the pits. Nice combo. Huge air. Oh, hard landing. Can he save it? He does. Brings it back on all 4 BKTs. Slaps it into the Metro by T-Mobile barrier. And sends it. Huge air. That's the biggest air off of that ramp. No doubt about it. Tom Entz is trying to take that lead tonight. Some more big air. Nice combo over the bus stack. Nice sky wheelie. Those rims really take a beating. As I see after a lot of his freestyles, they are bent up. Gonna go for the backside of the racing ramp. Nice air. Uh-oh, something's smoking. He lines up for the backflip. Crazy rotation, blows a tire, and he lands it back on all four BKTs, or should I say three. He gets RII'd though. 35 seconds remaining. What an incredible hit from Tom. If he could refire, he could go for the lead here. I don't know. He's fired back up. Fans, get on your feet for Tom Entz. He's going to venge on. Moves the barrier right out of his way. That poor BKT's holding on for dear life. As Tom's still going to keep sending it. He doesn't care whether he has three big KTs, four BKTs, three big KTs, or two. That's a tongue twister. Try saying BKT three times as fast, five times. As Tom Entz is coming over the bus stack. Huge air with three BKTs. Engine smoking. He's still going. Oh, no, he has another tire down. Tom is a crazy man. He's still going off. Two BKTs that are still inflated, and he is going off. Tom Entz doesn't know when to quit until the truck does. Oh, man. He's still trying to go. And he's going to park it at the barrier on two BKT tires. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Tom Entz and Firemax D as he is pumped up. His hands are in the air. He's saluting you fans. What did you think about that? What an incredible run from Tom Entz. That could definitely take the lead from Cynthia, but it's up to the fans. Instant replay highlights right here. Gets a huge backflip, crazy rotation, blows the tire, gasses it with the rear steer and brings it back. But we'll see what the fans think about that. Monster Mud Dalmatian still at the lead. Nobody has gotten into the nines. A 9.535, your new leader, Tom Entz, Fire Max D. Ladies and gentlemen, the black and green wrecking machine running for over 35 years. The headlights are on. You know what that means. It's gravedigger time. As you can hear that theme going off in the background, and the gravedigger machine driving off the pits onto the track. Another fan favorite truck. He's been running for so many years, an innovator of freestyle, Dennis Anderson is. And he's the one who created the face of Gravedigger and what it is today. As it looks like that Gravedigger machine is beat up from two-wheeler racing, whatever it was. As he's going to send it off of the bus stack. Huge air. Man. I believe that's either Morgan Kane or Adam Anderson. I do not know. You've seen Adam and Ryan at the same event sometimes, so I do not know who's driving currently. But the black and green wrecking machine is going off. They're drifting the turn. Big air. If I had to bet on it, I'd say this is Morgan Kane. As that Gravedigger body's definitely coming off right now. He's going to have a nice in-cab view and be able to see everything. Huge air! Oh my! He is going off right now. Body panels flying everywhere. Oh! A hard hit onto the right side. But that truck soaks it up like nothing and continues on. Might be a little bit of suspension damage, but that's not going to stop him. Huge air once again. Big rebound. Lining up for the Senate ramp. Flooring it. Huge air. Wow. Almost beats Cynthia and Tom. Oh, he's on this lid. Can he save it? He doesn't. Oh. Almost brings it back on all fours. But end short. As you can see, Tom at the top right, giving him the moves. He's saying, Gravedigger, you're not getting this one. If I had to guess on it, that's what I think he'd say. But, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to determine who the winner is. Let's see what score Gravedigger gets. I don't see him taking the lead. Didn't hit the backflip. Didn't fill time. But he definitely put on a show for the fans. That is indeed Morgan Kane. I was right. And he's climbing up onto the panels all the way up to the BKT and saluting you fans. How do you feel about that run? He's giving you guys a clap back. Let's see what Morgan Kane's scores are. Tom Mance with a 9.535 still. And Morgan's score comes in at an 8.518. You're a fifth place winner, which means you're freestyle champion, Tom Entz. Fire Max D. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to conclude the Minneapolis freestyle event in our commentary video. Your top three freestyle results were Tom Entz and Max D. Fire taking the freestyle championship with a 9.535. In second place, Cynthia and Monster Mutt Dalmatian Ice coming in at an 8.899. And in third place, Ryan Anderson and Sun UVA Digger at an 8.714. Your top three for tonight's freestyle. It was an incredible event tonight. I really enjoyed commentating it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to like if you liked it and sub if you loved it. And leave a thoughtful comment in the comments below on what I should improve or what video you guys want to see next on my YouTube channel. Once again, guys, I appreciate every one of you for coming out tonight and watching, and anyone in the future watching. And make sure to keep loving pizza and landing back on all four BKT tires. I'm your host, Avengers Racing, on Instagram and YouTube, aka Pizza Wayne, also on YouTube. Check out my second channel if you want to see some funny gaming moments and awesome gameplay. And hopefully I will see you in the next commentary video or next video I do. Have an awesome night, and I will see you then. This is Monster Jam.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing the bell.